Oh shit. Oh shit! Oh no! Oh fuck. Oh my god, someone's talking to me this whole time. Oh my god, I trusted you, chatbox. I fucking trusted you, chatbox. You betrayed me. He's a time traveler, I guess. Oh man, I missed the time traveler. Why was my chat box not working? Fuck. Well, now I'm just fucking pissed. I missed the time traveler. Alright, it's late. I need to go to bed soon. Not quite yet, though. I'm fucking around with OBS. Oh, man. Okay, so if you look at this, I made an overlay scene, and another overlay scene, you can't see it, but it just says the Streamlabs thing. I kind of want to open Streamlabs and test it. Streamlabs. Let me go to a face cam for now. Don't get the fucking cover image on there. There we go. Well, I had one chatter show up, and I fucking missed him, or her. Them. Okay, that's good. That looks good. That's all right. Yeah. I think. Oh, this needs a chat box. That's not a chat box. All right, I'm getting a little pissed. Copy chat box. Paste it in setup. Get that cover image out of here. This needs a chat box. Spotify, blah blah blah. It has the overlay. This one needs its Spotify fixed. Ocean, why have you betrayed me, Ocean? Andromeda. Okay. Cool. Let's listen to some aerospace.
They don't want to see a nigga come up. Nah. They don't want to see a nigga run up the spot. Fuck off the cops. Hop off the whip. Shoot up the block. Ain't no heaven for the kids with the chalks. When you run, but you saw how you walk. What would up on a Tuesday, party on a Friday, turn down on some side cake, turn up for the main bait, drink drag till I feel great, take drag till I curve straight, moon cuss on my birthday, sunshine, go blind, I'm a lion, strong roar but I'm dying, throw a horse, I go silent, play horse, I go Simon, so simple my mind is, my mind gets excited, take risks for no reason, no reason for lying. Sometimes when I go to work and I dream, why does it seem? Sometimes when I go to work and I think, why do I dream? Sometimes in my dreams I cannot breathe, why do I think that I could just be blind to the scene? I cannot see. I hurt, they're hurt, what's pain, who's worse? All cons, no perks, no songs, no verse. Sometimes I feel it can't get worse. I know if I don't stop, I'll burst.
Hi, Song. You're up late. Hella late. I am fiddling with all my OBS scenes. And also trying to get Chatbox to work. I'm doing it in a new way now. It's been kind of finicky and uncooperative. To get the general gist, and then if you have any questions, you can ask me. What would you like to listen to? Showing up, like I have a chat box here, but it doesn't show up until like Thank you. I'll turn the music down. There we go. Cool.
Oh my god. That's savage. Do you think Bert will let you not pay bills this long?
I mean, right though? You know how much I'd like let Evan get away with that?
By the way, I get paid in 2 weeks. That's mm-hmm. what I can pay you.
Okay.
I will. I apologize. It just sucks because I get paid bi-weekly. If I get a paycheck next week from my second job, I will pay you. But that's my time.
Okay.
Otherwise, I'm at zero.
I'm not going to send out the... I'm not going to pay for it until... either the last due date or when I get money from both of you, whichever comes first. Hopefully not before. This is gonna bother me. I want to make all these music players the same size.
Evan, side note, I appreciate your patience. I haven't forgotten it at all.
Here, I know what I'm gonna do. Can I do this? Copy these two and paste them here? No? Let me try this another way. Copy. Paste. Fair enough. Copy. I don't know how to set up my mic and my speakers so that like I don't get the music coming through the mic. I used to be pretty good at that. With the tape, whatever. I'll fuss with that another day, right? I'm gonna do one thing at a time.
Detail I'm missing is what makes you understand that she hasn't changed. What has she done?
I'll just do what she said. Maybe it'll get it. Note that, like, she and I did not... This was not, like, a back and forth. This was not, like, a discussion.
Okay.
Or an argument. She just sent me something, and then I just stopped talking to her. Can I copy this fucking text, please? Really, I can't. He's probably dumb anyway.
Yes. He had a baby raccoon in his hand.
That is actually... That, I would consider that a red flag. Like, people who... I don't know, man. Don't foster raccoons. Like, I like them too. They're cute. But I'm not going to bring one in my home. I feel like people who do that are kind of disillusioned. Oh yeah, I was doing a thing.
I wish I could have heard your side of things and your conversation without Evan, because Evan's...
contact with both of us on a regular basis. Which is a good thing. Because they should not be talking to each other.
Why?
Because of the shit that went down on Halloween. I'm not actually done. For whoever's watching, I'm not actually done. I'm just messing with the overlays. Or, yeah, the overlays. What? Where was my text? I thought I had end card text. Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez, Rick. Alright. What's this one? It's here. Yeah, that's did it. I got all my scenes figured out. Cool. Looking nice and clean. Next step would be if I really want to put in effort, get like a pretty border to put around anything, everything, but I don't know. I kind of like the minimalist thing. Whenever you call Anna out on something, she acts like whatever it is was like her idea. She's on top of it. She's the mature and put together one. And she starts like playing big sister when everyone knows that it's her that's the issue. Like she's like, oh yeah, I took time away from talking to you. Like I thought we kind of enforced that. Like, I thought that wasn't your choice. That was forced upon you, and now you're, like, claiming ownership, like, it's your idea, and you're doing this to, like, improve yourself. Like, no, Anna. You've been making the same stupid mistake for years.
I will say I was having some issues, and I talked to her. She's like, well, maybe you just need to go away and, like, be by yourself and get out of it. And I was like, just because you did it doesn't mean it's going to work for everybody else. Keep going.
I'm at a loss for words. Isn't due to not knowing what I did wrong. It's because I've understood what happened and have moved on with my life. So you've moved on without righting your wrongs. Is basically what she's saying. And she's like, I've moved on. I don't need to fix this. Which, I mean, I guess is fair enough if she doesn't intend to see me or each other again. If that's so, like, cool. Blah blah blah. We did some really shitty things to each other over the years. Fair enough, but within this past year, I don't want to like split blame on everything. It's been pretty obvious that I don't recall ever initiating contact with her in the past year. And everyone knows that for years I've actually trying to like low key get rid of her in some way, but like at a certain point I just get bored of fighting how oblivious conniving she thinks she is. Blah 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 blah. And then she's like, oh, things are so much better without you. No, that's not what she says. Maybe life without each other really is the best option. Yeah, no fucking shit. We all said that like three, four years ago. You're fucking late to the party, Anna. Don't act like you're the fucking enlightened one. I found peace in my life, and I'm working to surround myself in it. I hope you do the same and find a life that fulfills. Fuck you, Anna. It's the same kind of complaint you have about Evan, where just the way he says things on the phone, like, he's not, there's a certain level that you feel he's, like, not getting it. Or not helpful. It's that kind of complaint, but to the next level.
I got you. What, if I may, what specifically are you looking for her to apologize for? If it's not my business or it's too detailed, that's...
For inserting herself into Rachel and I's relationship and to forcing things on Rachel and forcing things on me and in general being a nuisance and kind of ruining that night. And I do actually blame her in part for why I'm not with Rachel right now. In part. I'm not saying it's all on her, not at all. But she was definitely a factor.
I will say, when I heard that they were making out that one morning, when we all slept out here, I was like,
did I tell you the story about when Anna first met Rachel?
She hated her, right?
Yeah. She thought she was like a fucking thought. And then when she realized that Rachel was not going anywhere and my friendship slash relationship with her was real, suddenly she's Rachel's biggest fan and starts trying to insert her into a relationship because she realized that Rachel's not going anywhere. And suddenly, her and Rachel are like best friends. You see what I mean? See how bullshit that is?
The story I got, what was it? Oh no, I don't even remember this. I remember Anna told me, because we were in the car, and we were going to like meet you and Rachel at the bar that one night. Anna was like, I used to be really mad at Rachel, and now we're okay. And I was like, oh, yeah. Why are we mad at Rachel? And she gave her answer, and I was like, oh, that makes sense. Like, that's really frustrating. But then, yeah, we went. She's like, don't be mean to Rachel. And I was like, well, I'm not going to be mean to Rachel. But I thought you were mad at her. She's like, not anymore. And I was like, I can't keep up, but okay.
See, she's just like conniving. She did actually...
I mean, I don't want to put my two cents and like muddle it, because it's not...
She wanted to appear to have like some sort of control and authority in the situation. But there was never actually an issue with Rachel. Like, why would anyone be mean to Rachel? What did she even say that was what was like wrong? Yeah.
Oh, I had no idea. That conversation was like
Yeah, everyone like at the house party thought she was cool. I'm upset because it's important to me to value people's free will and to like trust them and their words and let them do what they want, even if I fucking know that they're doing something stupid and know I know better. They gotta figure out themselves. Even if they've kind of broken my trust in the past, or lied to me, or gone back on their word, I do my best to trust people's words and what they say to me. And obviously that led to a lot of historical bullshit with Anna. And I am kind of pissed off that I feel I'm being taught that I actively have to distrust people and like arbitrate boundaries, kind of like not, almost like infringe upon like their goals and their free will in order to do the right thing. Because apparently the right thing I was supposed to do was cut her out of my life 2 years ago. Anna. Or at least this year when I started hanging out with Rachel. I was supposed to not even let Anna and Rachel hang out. That's supposedly the right thing I was supposed to do. But at the same time, I was not officially dating Rachel at that point. And she liked adventuring, going out, dating people. Like, I don't control her. I don't own her. Right? So I was like, even if I really, really fucking didn't want Anna and Rachel to hang out at all, like I said, I like value free will, and Rachel and I were not like a exclusive thing. So they wanted to hang out, and Rachel was kind of going with the flow, and Anna like kind of forces herself on her. Apparently the right thing I was supposed to do was to cut Anna out of the picture, like, confront her and say, like, stay the fuck away. They see how that kind of conflicts with my standards. It's complicated. It's shitty. Did she say that her and I are meant to be together? And at the same time, she was saying that to you. She was saying to me, no, like, I don't want to be seen as your ex. It's totally over. I'm not trying to be with you. I just want to be close friends. You see what I fucking mean? What a fucking cunt. There, I said it. I blocked her. I'm done with her. I could be mannerly at parties, but I'm not going to talk to her. Because she hasn't changed. She won't change. This is the first time in my life I've had to cut someone out of my life.
Really?
I have never had to, like, you know, cut that toxic person out of your life. I've never had to do that. Because I can be appeasing. I can be compromising. I'm pretty good at getting along with people. I'm, like, patient when they're kind of, like, unwittingly being, like, an asshole to me or taking advantage of me. I can be patient and put up with that and then eventually come to some kind of status quo. Like, if I don't like them, then I just, like, won't voluntarily hang out with them. But I've never had to cut someone out of my life. And I finally come to the point where, like, I guess I have to do that with Rachel. And I'm not really happy about it, but whatever.
Rachel or Anna?
Sorry, I said Rachel, I meant Anna.
I figured.
My
I was
bad.
Just checking.
Yeah.
Because we're talking about both. Besides that,
I was kind of frustrated that I didn't get much done today, even though, like, I technically didn't have anything to do after group. I got out of group at noon, and then I went to go get an admissions test. I failed the test. See this whole, I have to take this admissions test because, alright, I don't have the letter with me. I have to renew my license plates. And this just so happens to fall on a year when I have to get an admissions test. Even though I had one like 4 months ago when I had the title transfer. No, at the very beginning of 2018 when I had the title transferred to my name. I had an admissions test then and I passed fine. But now I have to get a new one. It's just unlucky that I have to have one so soon after. I failed the admissions test because my check engine light was on and he diagnosed it with his computer and said there's something weird with a catalyst converter, whatever that is. So now I'm probably gonna have to go and have someone diagnose it and fix that. And he said it's not really a cheap part, so I should have it probably diagnosed so they can figure out like the cheapest way to fix it and not, you know, like if it's another part, it's kind of not worth their time to tinker with it. They'll just replace the part because it's cheap, but I can't do that. So that was disappointing, because now I've got to go shell out money to have someone fix my car, and I have to wait more in order to renew my license plates, and that's going to cause some issue. I might have to like, call the state and ask for an extension on that, I don't know. But then after that, I was actually supposed to hang out with Rachel today. Like the first time actually just hanging out one-on-one, having a conversation in a month and a half maybe. And I've not been, like, talking with her much recently. I decided at some point that I'm just not going to ever initiate conversations with her. And if she actually wants to try to talk to me or something, then she'll come to me. And the other day she asked if I wanted to hang out and catch up. So, yeah. So we were supposed to meet up around, like, 4. I was done with my admissions test thing early, around like 2:30, so I was like, okay, I can hang out whenever you want, and I don't hear back from her for a while. I tried going to her place and ringing up in case like she doesn't have a phone or something. Then I hung out at Rochambeau for a while, and like after 5 she says, no, I can't do it tonight, can we try tomorrow at 8? And this is after her already rescheduling like once or twice. And, like, really not putting any effort into communicating with me or actually seeing me in person or trying to fix anything. I still kind of feel like she's just going to try to sweep everything under the rug and expect me to just be a friend. But she said that she'd be willing to talk at length. I said no to hanging out tomorrow, kind of on principle. Like, I don't want to have to do anything to prove a point, but I was kind of like, no, I don't want to get dragged around like this. Like, every time you want, like, everything we have ever done has been, I don't want to say something that extreme, but it feels like, and I know this is a rational thought, like, literally, my entire relationship with her has always been on her terms, on her conditions. And it continues even now, where it's like up to her if we talk, what we talk about, how we talk about it, when and where. Again, like, people taking advantage of my patience, my tolerance, my flexibility. So I said, no. I said, as much as I want to talk with you, it's become clear that I'm not a priority to you. I don't feel respected, and I can't continue a friendship like that. If you want to talk to me, you have to mean it, and I'm going to insist on talking at length if we were to try being friends. I'm not going to sweep everything under the rug and pretend to be okay. Neither of us want that. I waited a bit and thought it over and talked with some people, and I invited her to come here tomorrow. I'm not going to leave the house and or change her mind or something, and also I don't really want to talk about it in her place. So if she's really serious, she can come here. If not, fuck it. Whatever. Then again, as sad as it is, I'm maybe just going to have to accept that that's the kind of person she is, that I'm not that important to her, and that's it, and she's not going to change for me, and I gotta do my best to move on.
Is she still seeing?
Yes.
Okay. Did you ever go on your second or third date?
With one of those girls, yeah, and we've already said that we're just gonna be friends, so we're just hanging out.
Okay.
The others were either boring or stood me up, and the one girl from Waukesha is, like, kind of cool, but I don't really know until two or three more dates if, like, except she's actually cool. She might be a weenie. So I'm just gotta figure it out on the day to hang out with her. Like, she's in Waukesha, and, like, you know, it's a weird schedule.
What about that girl that you had over when I was over?
Yeah, that's the one. We're just friends.
Okay. Cool.
Honestly, like...
Her last...
I'm not even, like, trying that hard in this Tinder thing, which I guess is part of, like, why I'm having success and actually having decent conversations.
Mm-hmm.
But,
to be honest,
like, I feel like I'm just doing... I'm kinda, not completely, just doing it to... like, kind of be my own wingman and be like, oh, there's other fish in the sea. Just keep your eyes open. I'm trying to do that and not focus too much. But seriously, I don't actually think I could date anyone right now unless they're, like, super fucking amazing. Because I'm still going to be fucked up over Rachel for a while. Because the whole thing was way uglier than it ever needed to be. And I'm way more hurt than could be considered... necessary or inevitable.
Yeah.
See what I mean? Like, I just put up with everything, and no one ever considers what I want, how I feel, like what my thoughts, my feelings, my issues. No one cares until they become their issues.
How long was the beer in the fridge?
What?
How long was the beer in the fridge?
The beer that's in there now? Since Saturday when we had the gaming tournament.
Okay.
I'm handling my sobriety fine.
I don't doubt it. I'm just...
Here's a story. On New Year's... after, like, everyone had left, the last person to leave was Cody, because we were playing Smash Ultimate.
Mm-hmm.
He's, like, got up to leave, and he's like, oh, hey, I just opened this spot at Cowboy, I'm leaving. I'm like, can you take care of this? I'm like, sure, I'll take care of it. Because he doesn't know it's open. So he walked out the door. I'm standing alone in the kitchen with an open Spotted Cow, and I poured it out. It's not a big deal.
Mm-hmm.
Like, even then, it was not, like, a frustration or a trigger. I'm handing my sobriety fine. The bigger issue is this mental health shit.
Okay. I moved it to my bedroom.
Moved to what? The beer? Yeah, good. Because, Evan kind of, at some point, just kind of gave up on hiding stuff.
He's pissing me off.
He's just like, he hiding beer and just having weapons in the house.
I know.
Like, I'm kind of fine, I guess, but you didn't ask that. You're assuming that. And again, that just leads me back to that thought, like, no one actually takes me seriously. No one is taking me seriously. No one is taking my issues seriously. They don't give a fuck, because it's just fucking Mish. He'll put up with it, right?
You have to know that before you came back, I kept harassing Evan.
Yeah, but he won't listen to you, because he doesn't listen to you about anything.
I'm aware. But me and Meryl, he told me that same thing. He was like, Sasha, Mish can handle it. And I was like, that doesn't mean he wants to. Yeah, I know he can. He's an adult. He can. But he doesn't deserve to have to.
Yeah, he doesn't get it.
And me and Meryl, literally, after Evan said that, Meryl was like, Evan, God damn it, put the alcohol in your bedroom. Why is it so hard for you? And he finally moved it. Because we both yelled at him. But it's just pissing me off that he can't respect one of his oldest friends.
Yeah.
So I don't know. If you want me to talk to him, I can. If you want to talk to him, let me know. You're obviously free to do your own thing. But if you prefer me to do it, I don't mind.
It would mean more if it came from me. But, you know, I'm used to just putting up with it.
I know, but I feel bad because I don't want you to have to do that anymore.
Yeah,
I've
I know.
Seen what you've had to deal with, and it sucks. Not that I've helped necessarily, but it definitely sucks. Like, if I was treating any one of my friends the way Evan treats you, I'd be livid with myself. And I just want to do it, because I know that it's wrong, and it's inappropriate, and it's not respectful. Like, yeah, people make mistakes, but I swear to God, if Evan blames one more issue on his memory, I'm done. There's no way someone his age has that shit on him.
If he cared more, it would stick more in his mind.
I know, but his life...
It's not his bad memory, it's that he's not taking it seriously.
His life's motto is, like, apathy. And I'm like, that is the stupidest thing I've ever heard. And I can't wrap my mind around why he thinks it's a good, like, motto and word to live by. It works for, like, a third of life. Be apathetic. So, anyways, I will make sure that you can find out the truth. So that, like, this shit doesn't
It's no big, like, don't worry about it. It's like a day after a party or something. Just, you know, put it away later.
I don't know. I just don't know how to do it. Uh-huh. Changes, it's confusing. I was like, case in point, that's why you posted the schedule. He's like, well, why are you all uppity? And I was like, because you're missing very obvious things. You don't want to come home to my kitchen full of garbage. You could have prevented it. I'm so sick of not doing chores. For his cell phone number today. I don't know what that was about. She didn't tell me. It's not my business. but the fact that the landlord knew his direct number, that's a weird flag. So, let's see what that was besides the Rachel and Anna. Is there anything else that's ripping your mind?
Yeah, always, but like, I'm okay for now. I'm gonna go to bed soon.
This room? I'm actually jealous that I
did. Yeah, it's nice, isn't it? Mm-hmm. It does.
It's weird. Also, if I was to bring some of my sewing slash piano books, would you mind if I put it on the keyboard things?
What?
If I brought some of my sewing keyboard books.
Yeah. I mean, there's some books already out there. If you want to play with them, sure. Just be really careful with the books because they're old and like they might actually be worth a lot of money. Especially some of the like actual sheet music, because sheet music is very expensive, and those are like basically antiques. Some of it.
Well, no, I have plenty at my parents' house.
Sure.
You can't hear my TV at night, can you?
No.
Okay, cool. I'm so pissed that someone gave me crabs.
Ugh. What?
You saw that on the thing, on the chat.
Someone gave me crabs? What are you talking about?
I said, low-key, I might have crabs.
Oh.
And then Evan said, Jesus Christ, and he said, Superstar.
Oh, I remember saying Superstar, I don't remember the other thing.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I know, I'm pretty sure. I took care of it. Not that it would affect you guys. But I have sex slash, hookups, twice a year, and that's the extent.
Mm.
I don't have sex one time, I've done, twice a year. So I'm really upset.
Yeah, the fucking one time.
Yeah. And then I was talking to this guy, and he's like, oh, just shave. And I was like, oh, okay, so I did. And, it's been going away, I'm pretty sure that it didn't respond. But I went to the doctor the morning after I shaved, and she's like, well, since you shaved, which is probably smart, we can't have a determinate answer for your symptoms, because... shape. So I'm back in a week or two and we'll take another look. And I was like, are you fucking kidding me? Yes.
Mm.
What I was gonna say is when you were bringing up Tinder, honestly, I have the dating apps for the the Scruff and the Grindr. I just talk to people.
Mm-hmm.
I find it, I don't know, cute. And enjoyable at times. So, even if I don't meet up with them, sometimes just chat with people and see what's up in the world.
Sure.
Some people give you their life views and it's sort of insightful or sort of interesting. Some people just say hi and bye. I don't know. You get a larger sense of different possible personalities out there.
Mm-hmm.
Different demeanors, different text styles. I don't know. It's very interesting. Then I sort of get myself into a hole, though, because people are like, so we're going to meet up, right? I'm like,
I don't know.
Possibly. But I'm also talking to, several other people, and I'm also working two jobs and never home. So, yeah, we can get that drink in, 5 months. So,
long story short, or short story long.
I was gonna say, I don't know, I don't use apps for necessarily finding people to date. And I don't think it's apps, I use them to just chat with people.
Yeah. Yep. You know. I'm learning that I have to not expect much from people.
Oh, yes, correct. Unfortunately, it sucks. Yes, that's the thing. Like, even if I don't meet up with people, I tell them, like, hey, I'm just, it's not fun, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Or, I'll keep them updated. But other people, when I finally am ready to meet up with them, I'm like, okay, I'm ready. What are we doing? They, like, jog off to Facebook. I'm like, that was a really shitty time. Thanks.
Yeah.
No shit, Sherlock, I know, because you cancelled and they were static on your end, so obviously something came up. I'd like to know what was so important and why the fuck you couldn't just tell me quickly that it wasn't important. People are terrible at communication. We have all this communication at our fingertips, and people just suck.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not an excuse. Guys are like, oh, sorry, I was busy. Well, if we're making plans and you're busy, I expect you to text me because I know that you're on your phone.
Yeah, like Rachel did.
Oh, yeah.
It's amazing how, like, fucking frequently I'm basically being told by her actions that I just don't matter.
Do you prefer it as your bedroom, or do you prefer it as this room?
As this room.
Did you like sleeping here?
Yeah, I actually did like this as a bedroom.
I always felt that. Not that you didn't, you know, consciously change the room, but like, I don't know, I don't feel like anybody in general.
No, I was basically volunteered for this room. I wasn't completely unhappy about it, but it's definitely a situation where I was volunteered for this room. Again, another thing. Oh, just mission pull up with it. Why was I the one that had to park on the street all last year?
Well, that's what I'm about.
Because I'm fucking Nish. You mean they're empty words like, oh man, I'm sorry, I didn't mean it for it to end out this way. And you can park sometimes in the driveway on this or the district. Yeah. Shut up, no.
keep trying to text Marcos, and I keep forgetting that he's an hour ahead, and it's a work week. God.
Oops.
My schedule's awful. People are like, why don't you sleep? And I'm like, it's a lot easier to talk about sleep than to do it.
Simon what?
Simon saying, hey, who wants to get together and get some shit?
Simon says?
Yeah. I wish I could teach Simon that it's okay to not be dating someone that is old. He is so girl crazy. And I'm like, just give yourself a break. He's cute. It's so annoying that Facebook isn't like Grindr, where if you see someone cute, you can't just friend them on the flute. Ugh.
Life is pretty hard.
Right?
It doesn't look so bad. No, I kind of don't want that. I don't want that there. How do I do this? Man, I don't want to have to undo my whole overlay system. I mean, I could.
One of the most cringy things is when people put their arms up and you can see their ribs.
Cringy?
I hate seeing ribs. It creeps me out.
Oh. above the link. Yeah, I suppose. It's just, it's a pain because this, what you're seeing right now, this is like an overlay. This is one scene that I've already put together that goes over every other scene. So it's really simple that I just put that scene inside the other scene, and I don't have to fuck with it, and it like puts less items, less sources in each scene for me to fuck with. But having a way to have a little text, I want to have something on screen so when people tune in and they're like, what is this guy and why am I watching a stream of like some weirdo just like sitting on the couch, like what the fuck is this? I want them to see text that it says like that leads them to an explanation of what the Glasshouse project is, so maybe they'll find it interesting and follow. I don't fucking know. I want to have something like that. But I also just put all this work into these overlays, and now I'll have to like undo this one. Let's see, what's the easiest way I can do this? I can make two overlays, one for Fox Mish streaming and one for Glasshouse Project streaming, I suppose. Let's do that. Let me duplicate this. Overlay. Glasshouse overlay. And then I'm going to put that text here. And I'm going to... I'm gonna have this match the other fonts. Oops, don't want that. So this needs to be Avenir 5 view. Ooh, where did I get this influx of viewers from? Oh boy, 120! Gotta tune into Twitch and find some nobody on just chatting. I think this was Avenir Medium. I need to change that. Info here. Shrink that down. Oh, I'm a dummy. I could have just combined these. And now it needs to be wordpress.com/livestream/glasshouseproject. Let me find out. Two viewers. Neat. I don't know, man. foxmish.wordpress.com/theglasshouseproject. Okay, easy enough. Boop, boop. Here. Honestly, I could honestly kind of just leave that and people would like get it. If I just leave that, that would be, I don't know, people are like pretty, God. It's a pain that I can't have a link on my Twitch page. Like I don't think I can have like a description or outward links. And people are going to be really lazy and not want to type this in, you know? I can make a tiny roll, but that's lame and no one's going to trust it. I guess I will just leave it like this. I'll shrink that down. People will get the point. If they want to know what the fuck this is, they can go there. Right. Let me add something. Color source. I like to have defaults and kind of like walking on the text. Yeah, that looks cute. Get this out of here. So now I have an overlay for Glasshouse and another one for the other thing. One more thing. One more thing! That's Avenir Medium, and give it an outline, and put it down here. Boop. And I need that color source back. There, that looks good. Ooh, peekaboo, peekaboo, peekaboo. Yeah, whatever, that's good enough. Now let's rename this one. This one is the Fox Mesh Overlay. And now I need to change a lot of these things. Add scene. I should be in bed. Hey, look at that. Cool. Okay, good, good, good. Sure. Here, you know what? In this, I can add full link, the Glasshouse project slash. That's it, right? Did I spell that right? Yes, I did. Yeah. Okay. That's better. Same for you. Boop. That's fine. That's fine. And this one. Boop. Hey, I'm all done. Okay. I did it. Alright, I'm gonna go to bed soon. I can at least stay up the next 5 minutes for Handbrake to finish what it's doing. I'm having it process the last live stream I did, the last VOD, and put it into a format that I can upload to YouTube. And I'll start the upload on YouTube and I can finish all that in the morning. So today was kind of a whatever stream. I kind of spent a bunch of time fiddling with OBS. Excuse me, RIP headphone users, sorry. Do I want to end the night with? No. Yeah, sure. This looks like a good one. Let's see, what's on the addendum tomorrow? Or next time I stream? Well, for sure I want to play piano. Like, it's been too long since I've gotten to piano. So piano will be a priority. I've also been slacking on journaling, and there's been a lot of developments recently, so I should do that. It's nice that more and more I'm finally having a lot of stuff settled in OBS, so I don't have to constantly be finicking with it every stream. So maybe it'll be easier just to start up and get going. January 7th, 2019. Part 1, because there are multiple. See, what was I doing earlier on? I don't remember. I was kind of just fucking with OBS a shit ton, huh? Uploading stuff, fucking around. I updated the Glasshouse project thingy. I got dinner. Fucked around with the chat box a bunch. Finally learned how, and then fucked around with Streamlabs. Oh my god, I can't believe how long this all took. Yeah. OBS maintenance. Maintenance. No, it is maintain, right? Maintenance. I second guess myself. Maintenance. Alright, well fuck me, I guess. Maintenance. There we go. OBS maintenance. Update to Glasshouse. projects, I guess. OBS maintenance, stream lab fuckery. That'll excite people. I mean, the word fuckery, this gets everybody's giblets all in a jamble. I upload stuff to YouTube. Fuck with OBS. Scenes and chats. Set up Streamlabs. Gimmicks. Whatever. General maintenance stream. Enable age restriction, because I like to say cunt a lot. Then yeah, I can also get Handbrake working on the video I'm doing right now, and then we'll be all caught up. Who the fuck is viewing right now? A few of these people always, these names always show up like immediately, and they gotta be bots, right? They fucking gotta be bots. Or people who just like left the tab open forever. But who does that? Who does that? What was I doing? I guess that's it. Alright, yeah, bye everyone. Bye everyone! So yeah, I mean, come stop by, tune in once in a while. I might be doing something interesting. Who knows? Stop in, I might be doing something cool. Might be cracking jokes. So yeah. Yeah, if you ever like tune in to one of these videos and I'm not really excited for the first half hour, just give it a break, and if you remember, come back an hour and a half later, and I might be doing something cool. Because I do stream for a long time, and I know you only get like one alert in a day. And I don't tweet out these Glasshouse Project streams. I don't tweet out that I'm doing these streams. So you might not even know. I guess you'd have to follow me on Twitch and get notifications. Yeah, because I don't want to bombard people with notifications that I'm streaming every day. I would rather just reserve tweeting to when I'm doing Foxmish streams. Like the actual cool, interesting, concise streams on the channel that I'm aiming to go affiliate with. So there's that. This is all old news. These are things I've said before. I guess that's it. It is late and I am tired. I'll leave stream on for a little bit to let this playlist end. While I clean up. Yeah, sure, I'll let you guys hang out while I'm cleaning up. An itch in my ear. Itch.
Thank you. young, why did it die? And down the valley I see the country of my soul. It's a land both green and young, where the blue waters gently roll. Your folks live down by the lake. I'd see them for your sake, but when you turned away, they all began to fade like ghosts in the air, like they were never there. They all faded away like ghosts in the air, like they were never there. They all faded away. They all faded away.
Thank you, Robin and Linda. They all faded away.
Now when was the building burning with no one to put the fire out? Standing at the window looking out, out waiting for time to burn us down. Everyone's an ocean drowning with no one really to show how. They might get a little bitter, and if they turn themselves into a